Badges are helpful to notify the user about changes within your application. And we will look here at badges which you can put to any widget in Flutter. And secondly, we also create notification badges for our tab bar at the bottom. If you are new here, subscribe to my channel and make sure to watch this video till the end. Let's get started by creating badges for individual widgets, and after that we will create our custom badges. Therefore, to display our badges, we want to make use of the Badges plugin, and this plugin enables you to display different kind of badges. To create a badge, we start here with a button within our build method, and we simply wrap around our button a badge, and here inside you have a property which is called badge content, and this is basically a text widget or an icon, and within this text widget we can then display this number. And therefore I simply put here this count favorites inside, and here at the top in our state I create this variable count favorites, and this is then an integer. And to make use of this badge widget, you also need to go to your pubspec jaml file, and here you need to add this badges under your dependencies inside. And like you can see, now we have created here on the right side this simple badge, and it has a content of 97. Next, we also want to change here the text style of this text so that it gets bigger. And now it looks already much better. And if you like, you can also supply within your badge a padding. And I put here a padding to all sides inside, and then we have here more space around our text. Every time if we click on this button, then we want to also update our badge, and therefore I go to our button, and if we click on this one, then we want to execute here this count favorites plus 1. And with this we can now click every time on this button, and then you see that our badge is here updated. And if you don't like the animation every time when your badge gets updated, then you can simply go to your badge, and here inside you can set this field to animate, and then you set it to false. And now every time if I click, there is no animation anymore. Now we also want to duplicate our badge and create here a second badge. And the button is called then increase messages, and is always increasing here this another counter which I have created, and therefore we have here the 7 for this badge. Now let's look at the other attributes the badge has. Therefore you go here inside of your badge, and you can also supply a color. And here inside I set then a different color this time, and now you see we have here this orange color for our badge. If you like, you can also change the shape of your badge. Therefore you have here this shape property, and then you can set here for example the badge shape to square. And now you see that our badge has here this square shape. Right now our badge is here displayed at the end and at the top. However, if you like, you can also change it, so you can set here the position, and here inside you can then set the badge position for example to top start, and now our badge is here displayed on the left side and on the top side. You could also supply here bottom start, then it is here at the bottom, and you can also supply bottom end, and then it is here at the end and at the bottom. If you later want to hide your badge, you also have a field which is called show badge, and then you can set it here to false. And this is normally what you do then with a variable which you store within your state which has then true or false. Now we want to continue and also create here our custom badges for our tab bar. To create this bottom navigation bar, you go to your scaffold, and here inside you create then your bottom bar. And therefore I have created here this method, and here inside I have created a bottom navigation bar, and this has then here two items. And now that we have here our navigation bar, we also want to include here our custom badges. To create our custom badge, I go to the first navigation bar item, and this is basically here this favorites one. And around our icon we want to wrap another widget, therefore I create here this build custom badge method. And here inside I need to supply then later a counter, and I set it here right now to the count favorites because this is the favorites tab. And this count favorites is again stored here at the top what we did initially. And now we want to create this build custom badge method. And here we get then the counter variable which should be displayed in our badge. And first of all we convert this counter variable to a string. And then we create here our custom badge, and therefore I create here a stack. And inside of the stack we put then our child inside, which is here this icon in our case. And secondly we create our badge, therefore I create here positioned, and I put here the top and right variable inside. And within the child property, we put then a circle avatar inside. And now you see that we have here already our batch on the right side. If you like, you can also change the color, and then you set here the background color. So I set it here right now to white. And lastly, you simply put here a text inside, and you also give it some text style. And now you see that we have here our number within our batch inside. If our number only has here one letter, then it looks right. However, if I increase here this counter and we have more letters inside, then it doesn't look so great anymore. And therefore we go here to our text style and we want to change this text style depending on the length of our text. Therefore I go here to the top and I create a new field delta font size. And with this delta font size we want to decrease our font size based on the current text length. And therefore we simply go here down to our font size and here we subtract the delta font size. And now if I hot reload, you see that this number gets smaller. And in case that we have only one number inside, then it stays bigger and it will later change if our number gets smaller. And by the way, if you want to get here this whole source code, you can get it with the first link in the description. And with the second link, you can get access to my Flutter courses, where I teach you how you can become a more efficient and better developer.
Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel here to get the latest news about Flutter. And see you soon, bye!